Here's a look at our 2018 Platinum show cattle trailer. It has a lighted sign at the front and extra 3-light cluster on the nose. Spare tire. Come to there. The trailer has a stainless steel ramp, LED low light above the ramp, 3 air cracks with plexiglass. There's also a plexiglass holder container inside mounted on the roof to store your plexi when you're not using it. Upgraded wheels. We use these marker lights on the fenders so that when you use the lower tie rail, they aren't as prone to getting knocked off. You can also take out some of your plexi and tie higher if you'd like to. The rear, there's a load light, a full gate, and then a slider. And on the street side, if you look, there's a load light there as well. And then your escape door. It's on this side, also lower tie rail here. Full length. And then this escape door is also lined with rubber to help it be more watertight. As you can see, the full ramp is sealed, and so there's not a way for water to come through there. There's a look at the plexiglass tray or holder. It has a flap on it and you're able to shut it. And then the calf gate. Let me show you more of them to get in there. Switches for your lights, and then also the marker lights here on the back side as well, low, just to make it a little bit less likely to have those lights bumped off. Okay, in this trailer we have 2 center cut gates, both with sliders. This one is pinned back right now. Just to show you, those gates can come all the way back into the wheel well. Platinum puts a rail here so that you could pin your gate back no matter where it would be positioned. It's nice and handy. Then you just pin your gate shut. You can also open the gate the full way like I showed you, or just with the slider. We have tie rail midway. You can also tie on your gate rail if you would need to, since there's plenty that way. Just have the tie rail on the street side. As you can see, you can adjust these gates in 1-foot increments, so you could push them all the way up front. You can have them like they are now. However you need to make it work for you. Lots of times we do the sliding gate rail, so you could then push this gate all the way to the front like it is right now, and you have all this space for what you need. And if you need more, you can just move it back as needed. Added a light up in the nose just because it's an extra little feature that makes life a little easier. This cab gate just pins. I'll show you right now, but there we go. Here's another look. Another feature is that these upright posts on the sliding gate rail have additional posts up inside of here, so you just loosen this and drop it down. But the reason it's like that is for the wheel well area. When you go back into that area, you need them to be higher. So back here, you'll be able to drop this down if you're worried about that open area. You'll notice too that we also have the gates lifted 6 inches off the ground to allow for your additional bedding. And this trailer also has 3 roof vents, and then the extra with three LED lights inside as well. Sidewalls. With the sliding gate rail, you get the 5-inch uprights, which are even stronger. The length of the trailer. This trailer is 24 foot long, 6'6" tall, and 8 foot wide.